So, first off, I am unfortunately, or fortunately, in my opinion, not going to even attempt to review this film spoiler-free. The fact of the matter is, most of you will likely see this film in the next 2 or 3 days, and a spoiler-filled review will ultimately be far more satisfying and more interesting than one where I'm attempting to dance around all those major plot twists and talk cryptically about everything else. So, you have been warned, this is a spoiler-filled review. Now, first things first, I must absolutely commend Joe and Anthony Russo for, with such palpable passion, sincere care, and just evident respect, attempting the impossible. It was just so clear to me that those guys loved these characters, knew this world, and were just elated that they were the ones that got to deliver to us, to the best of their God-given abilities, what Marvel had promised for the last 10 years. As I've often described, the MCU really is the biggest budget television series in history, and this was their epic season finale, and for all intents and purposes, the penultimate episode of the entire series. And really what I felt like was promised to me with this character team-up film to end all character team-up films was, number one, exactly that. Every hero that I knew and loved from the Marvel Cinematic Universe teaming up and getting a chance to stand shoulder to shoulder against a common enemy, with heroes across the planet and across the galaxy. And number two, I felt like I was very much promised an epic, powerful, terrifying, and at least seemingly insurmountable villain in Thanos. And honestly, based off those two factors alone, Marvel Studios and the filmmakers behind Infinity War, well, they did it. And again, did it in ways that made me feel like I was not watching a couple of studio puppets dispassionately checking off a number of boxes, sitting around a table going, "All right, team, we've got to make sure that Thor has a poignant moment with Rocket, and that Iron Man verbally spars with Doctor Strange, and that, etc., etc., etc." No, while in each scene, I could absolutely see this film's director's complete dedication to and belief in that moment. And as such, I was able to invest in them and believe in them as well. And speaking of the character interactions, another thing that this film brought home to me was just what a great collection of characters this cinematic universe has assembled. And a testament to that really was just how much I cared for each of them in this film, even though in this film, none of them were really given that much to do. Which, of course, partially came from the fact that there were just so many of them, but also came from the fact that maybe this film was mistitled. Maybe this film shouldn't have been called Avengers Infinity War, but Thanos Infinity War, because this was his film, and he was far and away the most clearly defined character in it. Out of everyone, he was given the most attention. His motivation and mission to acquire the Infinity Stones center stage. And let me tell you, the way that they introduced that character, the Power Stone already in his possession, which insinuated that he'd already wiped out another great power, was so exhilarating. And then to have him so easily dispense of Thor, the Hulk, and Loki, the last of those characters, permanently, just heralded how powerful and driven that character was. And really, that drive was what propelled the entire film forwards. Our heroes, and we in turn, were rarely given a moment to breathe. The Mad Titan and his henchmen hopping effortlessly around the galaxy, taking what they wanted, and rarely receiving any formidable resistance. Even while Thanos was the one that received the most individual focus, the writers were still able to find a number of really key moments to allow our favorite heroes to shine. Scarlet Witch and Vision, their earlier scenes together, and of course their final scene, Thor and Rocket Raccoon, their quiet scene together talking about everyone that Thor had lost, and really any moment between Stark and Strange were just fantastic. I did appreciate too that even with its sprawling narrative and essentially countless characters, the writers and directors still did their very best to find something narratively and thematically to tie it all together. So while Thanos, with utter conviction, believed that he was right and indeed merciful for desiring to wipe out half of existence, we were also shown that he executed that mission dispassionately and in a way that refused to see that loss as actual tragedy. Even when he tearfully killed Gamora, he did so that others could die. An approach and motivation that so perfectly contrasted Star-Lord when he was ready to kill his closest friend and Scarlet Witch when she destroyed Vision. Both of them did that so that others could live. Connected to that, I loved watching Doctor Strange trade in his willingness to sacrifice Stark and Parker for a recognition that their individual lives were worth so much more than a relic, no matter how infinitely precious. The reason that the Avengers were right and Thanos was wrong was because our heroes were able to recognize the beauty and value of each individual life. Now, I've heard a number of critics actually criticize this film for never stopping or allowing us to breathe at any time ever, which I do find to be a slightly inaccurate criticism, or at least an incomplete one. There were numerous scenes that were slower, where characters stopped, conversed, bantered, and connected. The issue was those slower scenes were rarely connected to the ones previous. Instead, the filmmakers would get us all caught up in the action and intensity of one storyline, and then rather than allowing that storyline to slow and pause, they would cut away to a different one with different characters who may or may not have a quieter scene, ever creating the illusion that we were constantly moving and never resting. It should be mentioned too, if you don't already know and love the characters found in Infinity War, you likely still won't after watching this film. Each of them just given so little to do, certainly no full character arcs, and very few motivations beyond survival. And that really was why I mentioned earlier that what I think the Russos were tasked with was downright impossible. I really don't think that they could have made a better film than the one that they did if they actually wanted to include all the characters that they did. I just can't think of a single scene that I would have cut or shortened as to allow more time to be spent with other characters, like my personal favorite, Captain America, which just meant that each character was really only given a brief solo in this epic opera of a film. And really how that affected the film overall was the fact that it lacked an essential build. With so many characters, there were at least a few plot lines that pulled things in different directions. Great, fun, exciting directions, but different directions nonetheless, which meant that this film could never ascend to something as visually and narratively satisfying as that 360 shot from the first Avengers. Now, let's talk about death. Personally, I found it incredibly exhilarating that Marvel Studios was willing to kill off characters like, spoilers, Loki and Gamora. Characters that could have easily helped them continue to make millions of dollars at the box office where they kept alive. And they did so because it was right for this story. The gloves were off and the gauntlet came on. At the same time, and again, major spoilers ahead, but when Marvel Studios chose to turn half of their characters into ash at the end of the film, though undeniably heartbreaking for those left behind in the film, just couldn't be wholly affecting for me as a moviegoer, because I already know that there will be a Black Panther 2, a Spider-Man 2, and a Doctor Strange 2. As such, I just couldn't help walk out of this film at least slightly apprehensive. Will the very epic and weighty conclusion of this film just be nullified by Avengers 4? And even worse, will characters like Loki and Gamora, who really did die for something in this film, just be resurrected? At the very least, in Avengers 4, I don't want the unavoidable return of those turned to ash to feel cheap, inconsequential, or without great struggle and sacrifice. That would be a bit like if Return of the Jedi opened with the Emperor telling Luke that Vader wasn't his father and that that shattering revelation was only placed into The Empire Strikes Back to get us, the viewer, talking. All this to say, bravo, bravo to Joe and Anthony Russo for making a fun, epic, conclusive film for the Marvel Cinematic Universe. I'm just so thankful that they loved the characters the way they did and that they really did make as satisfying of a film as they did. And for all these reasons, I will give the film a 3.5 out of 5 and a heart. I would still love to know what you guys thought of the film though, so definitely comment below and let me know. And to just slightly mix things up for me, could you rank for me your Avengers films? Avengers, Avengers Age of Ultron, and Avengers Infinity War. Finally, please do subscribe. I'm going to continue to review films and television on this channel, and I would love for you to stay up to date on all of those things. But for now, I'm Chris Hartwell. This is The Heartbeat. Thank you for joining me.